Kids and Jam Friends. I have a question for you. Who is your favorite superhero? Is it Wonder Woman, Superman, Iron Man, Hulk, or Ruthie's favorite, Batman? Well, the Bible tells us about a time when God provided real heroes to save his people from some serious trouble. These people were not perfect, but the all-powerful God used these real men and women to help save his people. These heroes were called judges. They weren't like judges in a courtroom, but they were special leaders God chose to rescue his people from serious problems. We're going to hear about some of these judges this week. After God led the Israelites into Canaan, he told Joshua to give the people God's instructions about what they should do and how they should live. Joshua reminded the people of how faithful and kind God has been to them. He told them to serve God and obey him and warned them that living on their own or living their way was a terrible idea. Now, some Israelites who was led by Joshua and listened to him into the promised land, they obeyed God. But when Joshua and these Israelites had passed away and died, the rest of the people started disobeying God. They decided to depend on what they thought was best instead of listening to what God said was best. Soon, they started worshiping idols, false gods, sometimes hurting one another, and totally ignoring God. So because of their sin, and to help them see that they were actually doing the wrong thing, God allowed the Israelites to face the consequences for their actions. Because God is just and fair, because these disobeying Israelites were trusting idols to provide food and protection, instead of like the previous Israelites when they trusted God for manna daily. So God stopped providing these things. God was showing that these false gods, these idols, don't have the power. So when enemies attacked, the idols had no strength to protect the Israelites. Their food was stolen, destroyed, or simply didn't grow. The idols had no power to provide for the Israelites, and the Israelites had no power to provide for themselves. God allowed them to face the consequences of their sins. In Galatians 6:7, it says, "A man reaps what he sows." Our actions have consequences. A consequence is what happened because of something you do. For example, if you tell a funny joke, a consequence will be your friend will laugh. If you don't do your schoolwork, a consequence would be getting a bad grade. God made the universe and he set it up to work a certain way because he knows what is best. God doesn't tell you how to live because he's mean or bossy, but because he loves you and he wants what's best for you. When you ignore God's way and depend on your own thoughts and feelings to guide your decisions, you often end up doing things that go against God and that goes against what he is saying is right and good. Because of this, you can experience pain and sadness, and it can seem like God is so far away. Remember, God's way is best. If you have trusted in Jesus as your Savior, God has the power to give you victory over sin in your life. God gives victory. You have God's help to say no to sin and say yes to things that please him. And God doesn't want your life to be ruined by the consequences of your sin. God wants to give you the victory. So even though the Israelites' lives were being ruined by their sin, God still loved them and used these judges, the chosen leaders by God, to rescue them from their enemies in amazing ways. For instance, one time God used a judge named Shamgar to rescue the Israelites from their enemies. Shamgar didn't even have a real weapon. He only had a long pointed stick, like a spear, and God still helped him to defeat 600 enemy soldiers. Isn't that amazing? Now, to hear more about some of the other judges, go to the Hope Church website and watch part 2 of this week's sermon message video. I'll tell you all about the one and only female judge named Deborah and the story of Samson. So tune in again next week and go to the church website for more materials and resources.